Events have been held across Australia and the world to mark International Yoga Day. It's the first year for the event, declared by the United Nations on the recommendation of Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi.
They're LOLing their way to inner peace. One of the more modern takes on an ancient tradition.
In laughter yoga, we do practice laughter, which rolls over into real laughter very naturally and very easily. And this is a very valuable tool for everyday life.
Especially when people make terrible jokes.
Like that one.
There was also quiet reflection as the world marked its first International Day of Yoga. Narendra Modi joined crowds in Delhi.
I believe that today, on International Yoga Day, we are not only celebrating a day, but we are training the human mind to begin a new era of peace and goodwill.
Yoga has become one of India's most successful cultural exports, a multi-billion dollar industry being embraced by Australia.
It's really about understanding the body and connecting the mind and the body and the spirit, but aligning that with the, the universal consciousness. It sounds a little bit spiritual, but it really is. It's about finding inner balance, and that transcends all religions and all cultures.
Yoga has grown in popularity in Australia in recent years, surpassing AFL football as the 14th most popular physical exercise for adults.
And Australia, or Sydney being a very capital city, it's moving at a very fast rate. So if we're always in the do-do mode, there is no being mode, and yoga brings you back to the present moment.
Studies into the clinical benefits of yoga have had mixed results, but many who practice say they feel better afterwards. And that's reason enough for increasing numbers to join in. Brianna Roberts, SBS World News.